ISIS leader has been taken out. What have you learned?
That's right. We learned this just a short time ago. Coalition airstrike killing Tariq al-Harzi, senior al-Qaeda leader, responsible, and this is crucial, for moving foreign fighters and weapons into Syria and Iraq, but also for running suicide operations. U.S. State Department had a $3 million reward on his head. This is also key, Wolf, because al-Harzi, he's Tunisian. He's believed to be in charge of the group's operations beyond Iraq and Syria. And, of course, we saw an ISIS attack, at least one acclaimed responsibility for, in Tunisia on Friday, killed more than 30 British foreign tourists there. It's showing ISIS's power beyond the borders of Iraq and Syria.
All right, thanks very much, Jim Sciutto, reporting for us. Let's get some more on what's going on. Joining us now, the former chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, CNN National Security commentator, Mike Rogers. Thanks very much, Mike,
thanks for
coming in. First of all, what do you make of this? The U.S. taking out this guy, what's his name, al-Harzi, $3 million reward, big deal?
Big get. He did a couple of things. A, he was moving weapons, we think, beyond the borders of Syria and Iraq, which was helping out other affiliates. Secondly, he was the one that was coordinating suicide bomber operations. So they would use those suicide bomber operations in military tactics. If you recall, they'd send suicide bombers in, then they'd send troops in. He would also coordinate efforts for individual terrorist-type suicide bombing attacks as well. So this was a big get. It will be very disruptive to their operation for at least some period of time. Of course, the key here is if this is what they do and then we wait another 6 months, that lack of tempo will cause them and allow them to rebuild very, very quickly. And that's unfortunate if they let that happen.